Two, three, start.
Hello, I'm Sneha and I'm from ECE department. I belong to MBJ College. I'm in the fifth semester.
Hey guys, I'm Omal from fifth semester, ECE department, MBJ College of Engineering.
And we attended this RoboLabs workshop and we benefited a lot from it. We did a lot of things actually in this workshop, like Willows and JCB and this thing here. All of this we did and we found it really nice. It was really helpful, especially for a person like me who didn't know much about robotics. It was a very big opening and it gave me a lot of confidence.
So the RoboLabs has set up this lab in our college within before 10 days, and I've attended this workshop which has gone for 7 days, and there were a different variety of robots which we were able to make, like the robots called as Mobilo, Omibo, and JCBN and all that. So what we started was, we started with the basic model, understanding how the mechanism of the robot works first using PPTs, videos, presentations, and after that, once we get to know the exact idea of how the working happens, then we go into the coding part, and we were taught on how to code for the robots to operate. And then once we dump those codes into the robots, we were able to see the performance, how it actually works.
That's how it helped us a lot, because we went step by step and we could finally understand everything in the end. So today we'll be demonstrating this robot here. It looks very complicated, but it's actually so simple and it was coded with just 5 lines. So this is.
So the robot which you are seeing here is called the Flexo. So as you would have guessed by the look itself, this is a mechanical arm which can be controlled by the movements of the person wearing this glove. So the operation behind this is, like, we have sensors behind this glove which are called flexo sensors. They can calculate the change in the resistance depending on the change in length as well as area.
And in front here we have the servo motors which will control the motion of these fingers here. And we used 128 Atmega 128 microcontroller in order to program this.
So, for running of the motors, we have the relay motor drivers. We have a battery over here to power up the whole source. And as you can see, there are threads which are connecting right from the servo motor to the fingers. So they have been arranged in such a way that the motion of these servo motors can induce the motion in these fingers alternatively. So, calculating the distance of the movement of a hand, the same movement motion can be replicated over here.
It looks very complex, but it's pretty simple actually to code this, and it is very useful in many places. Like the other day I heard someone telling me that it can be used in places where it's very very harsh environments and very hazardous for human life. So such places, these kind of robots can be replaced. For example, when we use radioactive substances, it's affecting a lot of people. So in such areas, when we use these kind of robots, it can actually help those people.
So this model is just one robot of what we have made. Though it looks complex, it has been made very easy by RoboLabs for us by breaking it down into various parts and taking them step by step, so that we understand each part correctly with proper clarity, so that we will understand the concepts properly, and then we'll be able to develop more ideas like this in the future using the knowledge which we have gained in this workshop.
We really thank RoboLabs for giving us this confidence in robotics. Thank you so much.
Thank you.